you've got eye floaters and you're desperate for a cure. Then you hear about vision degrading myodysopsia, or VDM project, and its quest for a cure for vitreous eye floaters. Awesome, you think. Then you discover that they're asking for donations towards their efforts to find a solution, and you suddenly get alarm bells ringing in your head and you wonder, is this just an elaborate scam to get money off of me? In this video, I'm going to explore the work of the VDM project and why I'm choosing to support their efforts. Hi, Martin Aguzzi. This is Martin's Eye Tips. Thank you for joining me. This channel is dedicated to helping you to see better, see more comfortably, and also to be less anxious about your eyes. If that sounds interesting to you, then please hit the subscribe button, hit that notification bell as well, so you get reminded every time I upload a new video. So as you may have figured out by now, I don't believe that the VDM project and its research is a scam. That's because I've had the opportunity to talk to and be able to meet some of the team and people that are involved in the project and bringing it to life. So the project has been founded by Fabio, who has been busy assembling a team of passionate individuals from all walks of life and from all around the world, with one thing in common, and that is that they are all vitreous eye floaters sufferers, and they all want to come together to bring a solution to life. I've met a number of these individuals and I've heard their floater stories, which have proved to be both powerful and inspiring. So let's get into what the project and its objectives are all about and why I think it's worth your attention. I'm going to break this video down into the following sections, which I'll leave timestamped in the description box below. First of all, what's unique about the VDM project? The power of the crowd, the plan, where they are now, is a cure realistic, and should you support it? Now, the VDM project could easily be a group of people, a group of sufferers that come together to complain, to feel sorry for themselves, and frankly, not achieve much at all. But I think the key unique thing about the project is that led by Fabio, they've gone out to collaborate with an eye specialist in the form of Dr. Jerry Sebag. And I think this is a significant and an important move towards their bold goal of finding a non-surgical cure for vitreous eye floaters, or at the very least, a safer surgical alternative for vitreous eye floaters. The reason is because Dr. Sebag is an experienced ophthalmologist and a vitreoretinal surgeon, but he also does head up a not-for-profit organization called the VMR Research Foundation. VMR stands for vitreous macular retina, which is really the key areas that the foundation works in. From what I can see, the foundation is very well connected to a lot of universities, institutions that are all doing the kind of work that will be necessary to support the foundation in a non-financial capacity. So it's a unique opportunity that I think the VDM project has established to partner with Dr. Sebag and the VMR Research Foundation. So this means it's not just a community gathering together to talk, but instead real action can come out of the project. At this point, you might be wondering, what does VDM even mean? Well, it stands for vision degrading myodysopsia, and this is a term that I believe has been coined by Dr. Sebag himself to distinguish the difference between regular myodysopsia, which is the medical name for eye floaters, and what he is calling a vision degrading myodysopsia. So Dr. Sebag believes that clinically significant floaters that cause degrading of your vision is actually a real disease. Now, this is important because not all floaters cause vision degradation, but if one does and it can be linked to a disease process, then we can study that process with the hope of curing the disease, much in the same way that we would do many other diseases. Now, this would also make it a lot easier for big pharmaceutical backing to be established, or even government funding to speed up this work. Now, the VDM project has taken up the challenge of bringing people and experts together to find an acceptable cure for eye floaters, because there just doesn't appear to be the necessary big pharmaceutical support or interest for a treatment in the pipeline. Now, Dr. Sabag runs the VMR Research Foundation as a not-for-profit organization, and they're constantly fundraising themselves for the work that they're doing. So how does the VDM project expect to be able to fund and support the work of Dr. Sabag for the desired solution? Well, if you dig deep enough into the VDM website, you'll find and understand that they're actively seeking donations to bring their vision to life. Now, if you think about it, it's no different really to crowdfunding the research. And many of us will have given money to a crowdfunding campaign at some point in the recent years. The reality is, if people who stand to benefit from the research don't invest financially in it, it may never get done. Now, the guys at the VDM project, however, have been creative enough to look at other methods of funding, and in April 2020, I believe, they secured about $10,000 of monthly online advertising free from Google. After jumping through all the necessary hoops and proving their not-for-profit status, as well as also proving that the work that they're doing is much needed. So what's the plan? I mean, nobody wants to throw their hard-earned money at a project that doesn't have a plan. Well, firstly, as the name suggests, the VDM project is just that, a project. That means it's a work in progress, and that means that you should be clear that a treatment or a cure will not be available overnight, or possibly even in the very near future. There are four initial stages of their broader plan that I'll cover in the following steps. These are outlined on their website as well, and I'll leave links in the description so you can check that out for yourself. So first of all is phase one. So phase one is the launch of their website, vdmresearch.org, and also their plan to reach 10,000 people via their newsletter. So this really is all about gathering a mass of people who feel that the work that they're doing will be beneficial to them, and that they have an interest in the success of the project. So the link to the newsletter I'll also leave in the description box below, so you can check that out for yourself. And I think it's certainly worth signing up. There's nothing to lose, nothing to pay for, and you'll get a document with which highlights really the research that they are kind of working on, and some of their thinking and strategies about their approach to being able to find a solution. Phase two is to help the VMR Research Foundation for specific research projects. And this is described in the website as well, and for more details, I'll leave a link to that page in the description box as well. However, the Vitreous Macular Retina Research Foundation, to give it its full name, has three main objectives here, and they're currently working on this, and they have a monthly funding goal to be able to establish these three steps. So the first step is to discover the cause of eye floaters, which they believe will help them to be able to, in the short term, discover a cure, and in the longer term, to be able to prevent vitreous floaters. So the second objective is to discover the link between myopia and eye floaters. Thirdly, is to create and distribute a new type of questionnaire to help them accurately measure the negative impact that eye floaters has on people in a way that really produces data that can be analyzed and measured. Phase three of the VDM project plan is to create a huge pressure group to influence pharmaceutical companies and to get support from institutions as well. And finally, phase four is to develop a better treatment approach for eye floaters and to focus on prevention as well. So that's the broad plan, and it's ambitious to say the least, but there is an actual plan based on action and attached to an actual research capable foundation. As we speak, I believe that right now they are in phase two and perhaps early stage phase three, with a lot of work still needing to be done and actual research as well still needing to be done. So as I said earlier, this really is a project and work in progress that will be helped with more people getting on board. For more updates on their progress, you know, do check out the website, and it's also worth checking out the YouTube channel of Cormac on the channel called Cure Eye Floaters Natural Remedies and Solutions. He's a member of the team and he's certainly clued up on the progress of the project. I think it's a reasonable question to ask, and from an optometrist point of view, and even from what I know of the ophthalmology and vision research community, people are generally quite closed off to the possibility of there being a non-surgical treatment for vitreous eye floaters, you know, full stop. However, in my relatively short time of making videos about floaters here on YouTube, I've discovered that there is a lot of research that needs to be done, and perhaps some forgotten scientific thinking about the vitreous as well that could ultimately lead to a breakthrough. Now, the reality though is that we'll never know unless someone actually does the research, and Dr. Sabag is certainly someone that appears to have all the necessary expertise, interest, and a hope that a cure or a better treatment is possible for vitreous eye floaters. That alone, in my eyes, is a reason to be hopeful. Now, I caught the recent VDM project review video produced by James over at the World of Eye Floaters channel, and I definitely suggest you go and check out his video for his take on things if you haven't done so already, and I'll leave a link to that as well in the description box below. But he did raise some interesting questions that I imagine some of you may have about the project as well. So one of them was really around the support and how you support the project financially. You know, what's going to be done with all the money that people are giving, and how long will it take to arrive at a treatment and a cure for vitreous eye floaters? Now, from what I can understand in terms of how long it may take for treatment to arrive, I think it's still a long way off, especially when I hear that they're still needing to develop ways to image the vitreous better, because generally research hasn't been done into better imaging techniques for the vitreous. So currently ultrasound is the best way of doing that, but they are looking at developing ways of using the OCT scanning device to be able to look at the vitreous as well. However, I think that people have to accept this and allow the process to take place. I do think that with the right funding, things can move along a lot faster, and I believe that advanced level phase 3 of the plan that I outlined from the VDM project's objectives should at least be the focus for anyone choosing to support the VDM project and the VMR Research Foundation financially. If the project can raise enough support financially and by kind of mass community support via the newsletter, Facebook communities, whatever the case may be, then it may be possible for Dr. Sabag's VMR Research Foundation to get a huge funding from institutions or big pharmaceutical companies that will then mean that they need less crowdfunding money from individuals, and they can make a lot faster progress. Now, I must say, I don't get anything out of supporting the project or making these videos at all. So, but I do know that there are many great people involved in this project, and I do feel that it's a credible attempt to bring people together to get a solution to a very big problem that many people are living through. So while I'm not going to flat out recommend you go out and donate to the project without thinking about it, I will suggest that if you are an eye floater sufferer and it's making your life a misery and you want a solution, then there's no harm in checking out the website, signing up to the newsletter, and if you do end up donating, then I would suggest that you do so knowing that what you're really doing is supporting the project up until it can hopefully stand on its own 2 feet. Also, if floater sufferers who are often crying out for help don't support it, you need to ask yourself the question, why would anybody else support it? Leave me a comment. Do you think the VDM project is a good idea? Subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share the video as well to spread the word. And I look forward to catching you guys in the next video. Take care.